Okay, come on.
Look, you just got out of the hospital. You shouldn't be exerting yourself, Sonny. By the way, you know, you shouldn't be wasting that little energy you've got running secretive errands in the dead of winter, either. You know? You might catch pneumonia, and then you'll have to spend another 3 weeks in the hospital. I got it.
I'm fine.
Is that your code word for it hurts like hell, but I refuse to admit it? How's that? Better? I want you to rest. I want you to stay in this bed.
Plan off or some incentive.
You need to rest.
I've been resting for days.
You gonna be okay?
Now that I'm home.
I missed you every minute.
How could you if you spent every minute at the hospital?
Well, hospitals aren't exactly conducive to privacy. I mean, I missed being alone with you, without all the nurses and monitors and your attorney knocking on the door every... Let me get you some pajamas.
Oh, well, sit down. You gonna get what?
Pajamas. You need something to sleep in.
I have a bed to sleep in and a wife to sleep with. What's got you so scared?
I want you to rest.
You gonna buy me pajamas now?
I'm going to go downstairs and get your medicine so I can put it next to the bed.
Come here.
Sonny, don't pull on me. You're going to hurt yourself.
Then cooperate. Tell me what's wrong.
Nothing's wrong. You're home.
I'm home because I want to be, and you're trying to get away from me. Why?
First, you want me to leave you alone, and...
When?
At the hospital.
For 5 minutes so you can get some sleep. Now all of a sudden you're jumpy and you're looking anywhere but at me. What is it? You don't like the bandages?
I think that it scares me to think that I almost lost you.
Well, that's behind us now. I'm fine.
You're not fine, Sonny. You got 2 bullet holes in your chest.
I know the scars don't look good, but the bandages cover them.
It's not about how they look. It's about what they mean. I guess I live my life in denial most of the time. I guess everybody does. I mean, if you think about all the things that could go wrong with somebody that you love, all the different ways that you could lose them, I think that you go crazy. So you don't, you know, you just assume that everything's going to be fine. And most of the time, you're right. But then, you know, you remember that nothing is promised. And loving somebody with all of your heart can't make them live.
But it did, that's the point. I know the scars are ugly and I wish they were gone. Especially because it hurts you to look at them. But it's proof that I survived, that you gave me something to live for.
I don't want to hurt you.
Don't fight me, okay?
Good. I say rest.
I say no.
I don't think you're ready for me.
I've been ready for days. I want my wife. You know you want me to.
Now. You're so full of yourself.
What's to be afraid of? What if I promise that I'll yell? Minute something starts to hurt.
Oh. I'll make you a deal.
Oh, we're gonna bargain now.
Yeah, we are. Okay. You just lay there.
Mm.
And you don't move, and you don't do anything. Just like you promised.
I promise I'll try not to.
Sonny?
Come here, you talk too much. Yeah, it hurts right there. Yeah. Oh, man. Oh, that feels better. Yeah. A little bit. Yeah, right there. Yeah. Now it hurts, like, right up a little up more.
What about my face cards?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That hurts. Oh, that feels better now.
How's that? You in any pain?
Just the opposite.
I told you not to move.
Mm.
I don't see any blood, but I don't know. Maybe we should check your stitches.
Aren't you going to ask me where I went after I left the hospital?
No. You'll tell me if you want to tell me. Besides, knowing you, you probably just went driving around to tick me off.
I went to Lily's grave.
Oh.
When my heart stopped, I'm not exactly sure what happened, but I could feel Lily there waiting for me.
It must have been comforting.
She had her baby with her. When you were at the hospital, I went to her grave and asked her to take care of him.
Our baby.
I know it's a weird thing, but you know, it makes me feel a little better knowing that he's with someone.
Yeah.
But he loved kids. She was a teacher. Both my children were there. And I could feel them, you know. Wait for me.
So, you went to Lily's grave because you wanted her to know that you remembered what happened?
No, I wanted to get clear in my head. What happened, I still don't remember at all, but I know I had a choice to live or die, and I chose to live.
Well, you know, your heart stopped, and they got it started again.
I was in a hallway. And they were through the door in a garden. They were together, safe and happy.
I wanted to go through the door, but I couldn't. I couldn't leave you.
You know, when your heart stopped, I swear to God, for a moment, I thought that I would die too. Because I knew that I wouldn't ever, if I lived to be 100, find anybody like you again. And that was it. That was it for me. I found love, and I lost it, and I'd never find it again, and I knew that. You're everything to me. You're everything. Which is kind of crazy, you know, because you're not exactly the person I thought I would love.
You're not either.
Well, you're mean. When you're controlling and you keep secrets when you don't need to. And you give orders when you could just ask, and you don't even let me use my own kitchen.
My kitchen.
It's our kitchen, babe. That's my point. See, we're married. And you don't hear things sometimes that you should. And you'll never say things. Certain things that I need to hear. There's so many things that you're never going to be able to give me, but you know, it doesn't matter. Because I love you. And you just make me better than I've ever been in my whole life. And if you ever come this close to dying again, I swear to God I will make you pay.
Hey. I know what it costs you to be with me. I know what it takes to let somebody in. Knowing that, you know, they could be gone.
It's okay. You're worth it. Loving you is worth, it's worth anything.
Good part.